Windows 7 is still running on at least 100 million PCs worldwide. So these are some strategies to safely use Windows 7 online, now and in the future. Keep your browser updated. Browsers do not automatically update like some software does. For most browsers, you can check for and apply updates in the About section. Check your browser settings. In whatever browser you choose, there are settings for privacy and security. We want to look through these settings and adjust them to be more cautious and restrictive. Let's start with Edge and highlight a few points of interest, starting with the Strict setting for tracking prevention. The tracking prevention feature in Microsoft Edge protects users from online tracking by restricting the ability of trackers to access browser-based storage as well as the network. Websites use trackers to collect info about your browsing. Some trackers collect and send your info to sites you haven't visited. The Strict setting blocks a majority of trackers for all sites. Next, we want to toggle on Send Do Not Track Requests. And Toggle Off allow sites to check if you have payment methods saved. Under Use Secured DNS to specify how to look up the network address for websites, select Choose a Service Provider, and pick a security-focused DNS provider like Cloudflare, or enter your own preferred provider. From here, we want to toggle on Enhance Your Security on the Web and set it to Strict. Now let's take a look at the settings for Google Chrome. Under Privacy and Security, click on Security. Under Safe Browsing, select Enhanced Protection. Then scroll down to the Advanced section. Toggle on Always Used Secured Connection and Use Secured DNS. Pick Custom and select a security-focused DNS provider like Cloudflare, or enter your own preferred provider. Then we want to switch to Cookies and Other Site Data and toggle on Send a Do Not Track Request with your browsing traffic. Moving on to Firefox. In the Settings menu, click on Privacy and Security. Under Enhanced Tracking Protection, select Strict. Under Send Websites a Do Not Track Signal that you don't want to be tracked, select Always. Now to switch to the General tab, scroll to the very bottom. Under Network Settings, click on the Settings button. Scroll to the bottom of the next window and mark Enable DNS over HTTPS. Pick a security-focused DNS provider like Cloudflare, or enter your own preferred provider. Next, we need to talk about ads, more specifically, blocking them. Edge has many options available for ad blockers. For demonstration, we can use Adblock Plus. You may notice after adding the extension that websites don't have as many ads on them, but that's just on the surface. Adblock Plus has some additional settings that are worth taking a look through. Under the General tab, mark Block Additional Tracking, Block Push Notifications, and Block Social Media Icon Tracking. Then scroll down to the Acceptable Ads section. This is personal preference. Showing acceptable ads allows ads to play on YouTube, so your favorite creators can make a few extra dollars when you watch their videos. Now to switch to the Advanced tab. In the Filter Lists section, you can add additional lists. There are some great filter lists available from adblockplus.org, like anti-circumvention, malware protection, notification blocking, and more. In the same vein as ad blocking and security, there is a tool called Spybot Search and Destroy. This has a feature named Browser Immunization. The process has a cool progress bar and really feels like something happened that makes you a little safer online. What it does is add entries to the Windows hosts file, which effectively blocks communication to those domains. You can manually add entries to the hosts file as well. Browsers have a tendency to ask if you would like to save usernames and passwords when you sign into a website. The built-in password managers are lacking in a number of ways, but the idea is an excellent one. There are third-party tools like KeePass that can manage your passwords. It even has a feature that can generate new passwords for you at various strengths and lengths. Nobody likes to key in passwords, and the average user has over 100 passwords in use. Using a password manager is a must if you want to stay safe online. Use two-factor authentication. For any service that offers it, turn on two-factor authentication. Yes, it is an additional step when you sign in, but it's well worth the inconvenience, especially if you still use Windows 7. That extra step can be the difference between safe and sorry. I would be remiss if I didn't mention virtual private networks. I'm sure you've seen many and various sponsored ads for VPNs, like this one.
Browsing the internet can be risky business, so why don't you protect yourself and browse anonymously with a hidden IP?
The bottom line is that it would be safer to use a VPN than not. These are the strategies for how to stay safe online using Windows 7 in 2022 and beyond. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.